The main purpose of the key management system is to unify the way to manage and use cryptographic key in your platform. To minimize the key value exposure, each key will have a unique identifier, and the API will rely on this unique identifier. ST implemented the standard API PKCS 11. The main services of this system, management of cryptographic objects like key or certificate, and classical services like encryption, decryption, signature generation and verification, key derivation or generation. In the KMS, we've got three main categories of key. Static embedded key are predefined and embedded in the code. They can be updated. Then we've got the updatable keys with static ID. The ID is predefined in the system, but the key value is updatable afterward in a secure way. In a secure way means integrity, authenticity, and confidentiality of the value of the key is guaranteed using some static embedded root key. Last category is the updatable key with dynamic ID. The key value is created using an internal function, typically a key derivation from another key. Here is an overview of the KMS system. At the first step, only static embedded keys are available. KMS allows to provision new key value for a predefined identifier. For this, we will need to generate a container, also called blob. In this blob, we will have the new key value, which is encrypted. Associated with this one, we've got some metadata which allow the KMS to check integrity and authenticity of this encrypted key before installing it. Then the application could use those keys through identifier than the PKCS 11 API. Application can also create new keys using internal function. Thanks to the software architecture, you can easily isolate the KMS from the rest of your platform, thanks to hardware mechanism available on your target. This slide shows how the key provisioning songs KMS is integrated with SBSFU in our code example. The key value to provision is encrypted. This encrypted value and some associated metadata will be stored in a container called a blob. The metadata include a header with a magic, a protocol version, a blob size, and the hash of the key value to provision. Metadata also includes the signature of this header. To provision a new key, the blob should be downloaded inside a downloading slot. This will be addressed by the loader of our system. The new blob then will be detected on the SBSFU execution. On this one, we'll call the secure update services of the KMS. The procedure then is to check the header signature on the static key. This will guarantee the authentication and the integrity of the header. Then the key value will be decrypted and the hash of the content in clear will be checked. If those steps are OK, then the key value will be stored inside the non-volatile memory associated with a predefined identifier. The key value is now provisioned and could be used securely. ST delivers the KMS middleware in the STM32W Hellcube firmware package. You can also find some basic examples, but also some more advanced examples with a full integration of the KMS with the SBSFU. Thanks for your attention.